half or so. Let's put some of these points. Rohit Srivastava of IndiaCharts.com. Rohit, thanks very much. Great to have you here. Your thoughts, Rohit? You've been, you know, pretty steadfastly bullish on markets for a while now. Where do you stand?
Thanks, Prashant. And that is true. And also, there's been a lot of expectation that the market would probably break the 14,200-300 support zone. And decidedly, despite all the news that we've had, both domestic and global, we've actually not done that. So I think the only pain point is for people who trade the Nifty. Over the last 2 months, they haven't had a trending move like they were getting before. And therefore, people who are only looking at the Nifty are probably in pain, is what I can say for the last two and a half months. But when you look at individual stock and sector performance, you actually see a lot of strength. The weakness, which was actually there in, say, the advanced decline ratio till the month of, April, we've actually seen it pick up pretty strongly in the month of May. So the broad market started to participate. Individual sectors have done well anyway. And so that overall gives you a picture that we have a strong underlying market. I think it's mainly the large caps that needed to catch up. And once the news flow around the pandemic starts to ease, you'll actually start seeing the Nifty starting to attempt a breakout. So just looking at the levels, I think the key supports right now are 14,640 for the Nifty, which is the 20-day average. Similar level for the Bank Nifty is 32,500. And if it holds that, I think you'll go to test the breakout point, which is going to be at 14,930. So once you go past 14,930, then I think you'll go back to the all-time highs again, which is closer to 15,400. That's the thing to watch out for now that the news on the pandemic side is beginning to slowly ease. The market will slowly get that buying support around large caps and make an attempt to break out again.
Rohit, morning. This is Reema here. What have you made of the metal moves? We had a ferocious up move, but since last week, we've seen a bit of a correction, and even today. Your thoughts on the way forward?
So the metal index, I think, has been one of our foremost picks for doing well on a long-term basis, which is almost a 2-3 year kind of view that we took last year. So that doesn't change. So one is that, the long-term trend still remains bullish. In the short term, I think the pressure may remain. The stocks actually got very overbought because initially it was only Tata Steel. Then each and every stock in the sector moved up, that their RSI, which is the relative strength index, all ended up reading above 80 simultaneously. And so that brought in a kind of near-term overbought situation for the sector. Now you've seen that sharp correction, especially on Friday when some of them fell 5-8%. I think there's still pressure in the short term simply because the dollar index, which is the primary indicator we look for the commodity cycle, might actually bounce back to around 91.60 is what I'm sensing. Unless it breaks the recent low, that move higher little bit, I think, over a 1 week time horizon is still open before it starts to fall again. So that will keep the pressure around the metal stocks. Even they may bounce around up and down a bit. The downside may be limited, but you'll see that pressure in the metal space. So I think metals probably only pick up later in the, after that bounce is over, maybe in the later part of the month or in June. In the meantime, the focus may shift towards other sectors, which I think are likely to be the public sector stocks, which have been in the limelight, I think, through last week also when the metals were correcting. And today we're actually seeing strength. In fact, even on Thursday, we saw strength in the public sector banks. So within the PSU space, even the PSU banks are actually doing pretty well. So I think these two are where I'm going to be focused over the next couple of days. We'll avoid metals. We'll also probably avoid pharma, which has done very, very well. The healthcare stocks also look a little exhausted. When I look at the Nifty Pharma Index, I see a sort of a negative divergence in the momentum. And that can actually bring it down a little bit from where it is. And that also might be a sign, that markets are likely to do well because money might be moving away from the defensive stocks back into the cyclicals and, market-related stocks. So that also might be a sign that the weakness in pharma is a move of money back towards the mainline indices. So that's how I see these sectors playing out.
Rohit, by the way, just a quick check. On Wednesday or so, did you put out a call on, a little bit of near-term caution on metals? Last Wednesday, that is?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. So I thought it could have been a slightly bigger
correction. All right. So that,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, somebody had pointed out to me, so great call, by the way. So absolutely, it's worked out very well. So you said PSU banks, public sector is the theme to trade on the long side, PSU banks in particular. Which names there, both sort of banks and non-government companies? I mean, government
So one
companies,
name
not
I'll
banks,
point.
sorry. Yeah.
Let me name out one name which we also hold on for keeping the next 1 month in mind, which is State Bank. That's the largest PSU bank, and I think that's likely to play out again because it's been through a long pullback. And when we look at all of them, also the PSU banks have had a 50 to 60% retracement. Okay, so even if I look at some other names, say for example Bob, again one where we have interest. It's done a 61% retracement of the entire rise that it made in the previous quarter and month. I think from the peak that they did somewhere in Feb or March, and I think after that they're probably going to pick up again. So we are seeing that across the PSU banks, deep, nice corrections, and the momentum has picked up over the last couple of days.
Rohit, thank you very much for joining.